Hello guys, I'm Tim Klenk with MasterTech, America's number one bumper-to-bumper service collision renovation and integration center here in Elkhart, Indiana. Today I've got a 2023, it's a Midwest Automotive Designs Group Mercedes van conversion, and the customer is out of the southern states, and they use this as a tailgating vehicle or transportation type vehicle. The problem is they needed AC going down, you know, with the engine not running in the back of the coach. So we've integrated a full lithium package to the back of the vehicle. We upgraded the inverter system to a 3000 watt inverter system, and we installed an efficient air conditioner on the top of the roof. And then the customer asked Midwest, they said, where do I go to get something done around here regarding off the wall, lithium, solar, air conditioner, whatever? And the Midwest said, you need to go to MasterTech, and you gotta come in and check this thing out. So integrating in this coach, it did not have off-engine air conditioning. So when the engine was running, yes, you had plenty of air conditioning, but this customer does tailgating, goes to the football games. And of course, when you do tailgating, the engine's not running. So we integrated a full air conditioning system, really efficient for operational use. So this is actually running on 120. In the seat back here underneath, we integrated a dual Lithionics 320 amp hour battery system. And that is all a UL approved BMS and battery system. And then in the back, we integrated a full 3000 watt inverter system to handle the air conditioner. Guys, I'll tell you what, this is the nut, because we've operated this in the heat mode and air conditioning mode for over 2 days off of this battery system. There's no other system out there. Again, this is a small space. If you have a van of any manufacturer and you have it as a camper and you want to live off the grid, you can add solar to this if you wanted to. You can do a lot of different things, but over 2 days of runtime off of just battery system, running a full 13.5 plus air conditioner is off the chart. So if you want to have something done, come to MasterTech. We will take care of you. We will convert any coach, no matter what you got, whether it's just a van or it's a big Class A. We've got 45 footers out there and above. So like I said, you know, if you want to have something done, come see us. So sitting inside the vehicle once again, I wanted to point out a couple features that the Lithionics platform is about and which we installed. So originally, again, this had the non-UL compliant battery systems and not for high amperage use, such as a 3000 watt inverter system. So this is the control panel that was original to the inside of the coach from Midwest Automotive Group, in which you can see that the house voltage is at 13.6, and then it has a chassis voltage feature as well. But what I wanted to point out, in which we've done several upgrades on, is a lot of the Winnebago type products and other battery products that are coming out where they just have one 320 amp hour battery. They're actually coming to us and having additional batteries put in them, which the Lithionics platform allows you to be able to do. So on this particular one, you do have a separate switch here for each one of the batteries. So if you actually buy a vehicle and it has two switches like that, yes, they are independent switches, but they are supposed to be turned on and off simultaneously. So you just hold the buttons for 5 seconds, and that's what turns on the battery system itself. So in the back of the coach on this Midwest van, we've installed a 3000 watt Xantrex inverter system, along with our Victron Energy Distribution Center. Other things that we've added to this coach as well is we had to add a dual lithium charging system. In other words, the standard alternator off the coach charges the lithium battery as well as the engine battery. But lithium batteries charge at different parameters, so we had to install a device to be able to do that. The Lithionics platform also is capable of emergency boost starting. So we installed an emergency boost starting system up in the front of the coach as well. So again, this is the back of the bathroom, all neat, tucked in and everything. Customer's gonna be wow factor on this one, guys, in which these two batteries were actually up underneath the front of the hood. Now, this particular battery is not what we call a sustainable battery system, let alone it is not a full UL compliant battery. So in this particular battery system, you are not supposed to be laying your head down at night. The reason why, they have temperature sensors in them, but there's no heating abilities to it. This particular system was up underneath the hood on the van. So if you're using a vehicle and it never gets cold, you know, I guess a vehicle or a battery system like this would work. The problem is this customer wants to run a 3000 watt inverter system to run an actual air conditioner. These type of battery system is only rated for 100 amp hours on the BMS that's internally inside the battery, maximum 200. Well, a 3000 watt inverter system pulls much more than that. So we integrated the full Lithionics package, just two 320 amp hour battery systems. So basically this is 100. So each one of our Lithionics batteries is 320 amp hours, but yet it's smaller than three of these combined together. So, and it is a full UL compliant battery on the BMS and the actual cell. So going into this over here, we upgraded the inverter system to a 3000 watt inverter system. Going down, we have our Lynx distribution, because the way everything was put into the van, it wasn't split up. So individual circuits weren't actually separated. It was all done to a B-plus stud. That's not the way you do for safety in the RV world or in the mechanical world. Everything has to be fused accordingly. So we installed a Lynx distribution bus by Victron Energy. This one here, this is actually your battery disconnect. It disconnects your house power. Not battery power, but house power. So we're gonna go around to the front of the vehicle and we're gonna show other items that we did on the inside. So on the inside of the coach, on the driver's side, we had installed a dual battery switch. This is for emergency boost starting your engine batteries. Should your engine battery be low and you want the lithium batteries to actually boost start the engine, the Lithionics platform allows you to be able to do that due to the redundancy and the superiorness of their BMS system. So dual battery switch. On the other side, you have your master power on off. That's for your 12 volt. That actually controls all your lighting within the coach itself. So in the event that you just want to do a master power kill while you're driving down the road, somebody leaves on the light, they shut it off, you actually just push that button as well. So going around to the front of the coach, on the front of the Mercedes, the manufacturer installed two lithium batteries up in the front. So one on the left, one in the back. Those were 100 amp hour non-UL BMS batteries. So those batteries are not made for temperature sustainability in the colder climates. So our Lithionics platform actually has individual heaters within the batteries themselves. Should it get below a certain temperature, the heater actually turns on to allow continual use and safe charging of the battery system. So over here, we actually have our controller. This controls the charging for the Lithionics going to the back. So the alternator on the engine is actually charging both the engine battery and the lithium batteries in the back. So this relay safely controls those properties. Down below is your emergency boost solenoid itself. So that is what toggles to the switch on the inside, which allows you to be able to boost start the motor. So if you need renovations, integrations, and you want top-notch service in the RV industry, van industry, whatever industry you got, come to MasterTech. We are America's number one bumper-to-bumper service, collision, and renovation center here in Elkhart, Indiana.